We shall now go on to our next speaker, Dr. Pragya Saini. And our discussant would be Dr. Mahipal Sachdev.
Good morning, everybody.
You have to be louder.
Okay. Good morning, everybody. The topic of my thesis was comparison of Barrett's universal 2 formula versus Barrett's TK universal 2 formula for the IOL power calculation. So this all stemmed from the fact that there was initially we measured only the anterior keratometry for the IOL power calculations, and so the need for total keratometry came to view. So this was about replacing the assumptions with the measurements. The purpose was TK was to replace the standard keratometry, aiming to help to reduce the outliers and improve the refractive outcome of the IOL power calculation. The total keratometry was a new measurement. This was combining the telecentric keratometry and swept source OCT technology for assessment of anterior and posterior curvature of the cornea. So this one was ULIB compatible and therefore could be used using existing standard formulas, and IOL constants could be applied in this. The same basic model of three-zone telecentric measurement using the swept source OCT. This is the toric model, and then this actually predicts the posterior corneal curvature much better than it was before. And thus a total cornea keratometry is measured using the anterior and the posterior values. So why the new corneal, why the new total keratometry was, it was established by various studies by Koch et al, which showed that when compared to anterior and posterior, posterior can significantly influence the IOL power outcomes. This is the study that proved it. In also, it was proved by the refractive residual astigmatism that was found after cataract surgery with toric intraocular lenses by Dr. Savini. Various other studies proved the same. And so we wanted to see if it was any different from the Barrett's universal 2 versus the TK formulas. So because the loading of the program itself costs about 15 lakh rupees in your IOL 700, so if it was worth it or not, we wanted to know. So the Barrett's TK Universal 2 and Barrett's TK Toric were the formulas that allowed the use of actual posterior corneal measurement, and it was only available if the Barrett suite and total keratometry licenses were both activated, which is the cost here. So it was done in Eye Care Hospital in Noida, and the study design was a prospective and interventional comparative study. The intervention was fake emulsification done by a single surgeon, so the SIA was reduced there, using a single piece Bausch-Lomb Invista lens used in all our patients, acrylic monofocal IOL in the bag implantation using a clear corneal incision. The duration was 1 year, it was January 2019 to October 2019, the year we established this. And method of measurement was the outcome, was the refractive outcome measurement after the cataract surgery. So basically our inclusion criteria included all the patients who gave consent, astigmatism of less than 0.5, uncomplicated cataracts, and all those who had anterior or posterior segment pathologies, uncontrolled systemic illnesses were excluded. So coming on to the demography, so basically what we did was we used the data entered in the MS Excel sheet, and the analysis was done using a SPSS 21 software. Descriptive statistics were used for variable in the form of mean standard deviation, and quantitative variables and proportions were measured using box charts and plots for the categorical variables. Normal data was tested by histogram and Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, and quantitative were measured using t-test for parametric and non-parametric for Mann-Whitney U test. So a two-tail p significant value of 0.5 was measured. This showed that keratometry values for both TK and K were lower, not significant. On plotting them in Blunt-Ollmann comparison charting, there was significant agreement between the TK and K values. And it was significant to see that we allotted them by the APE values, which is the absolute predictive error. And the absolute predictive error was significant in the 0.5, 0.25 and the 1 diopter, and not in the 0.5, where the TK showed slightly slightly more predictive outcome, error outcome. And so this was also seen by Dr. Melis where compared to other formulas, but we did compare Barrett's TK with the universal 2 formula, which was not done before. So we do want to include the toric formula as well later on.
Dr. Mahipal.
Thank you very much. I actually couldn't. What is the take-home message? What have you kind of concluded? I think these things are pretty much known.
In my case, the null hypothesis was proven, saying that the TK was not better for the spherical equivalent. But the study that we did later, like I'm continuing it with the toric. So the toric power for the TK, toric formulas, they are significantly better. So for spherical IULs, we don't really need to upgrade it until unless you are using a software.
That's a no-brainer. It's supposed TK is used only for toric, right? So for spherical, you really don't, if it's not coming either ways as a this thing, because you took all cases less than 0.5, right?
Right, sir. But so again, sir, the studies before Dan was showing that there were slight IUL surprises by using anterior segment only, and the TK would prove to be slightly beneficial. So those studies, that is why we took toric in for spherical first and then for TK, toric later.
Okay. And how were the eyes marked? Digitally, manually?
So we were not using toric.
Okay.
So
you didn't, sorry.
Yeah,
okay.
This is only spherical IUL.
Okay. That's it. Thanks.